Hi there, Michael Bobe with Consumer Recovery Network, and I'm back to do another reader question video answer. This one's a little bit detailed, so let's get started. I have credit card debt worth $42,000, 5 credit cards, and personal loan worth about $18,000. Most of the debt accrued was in the past 1 year in the form of balance transfers and cash advances. Uh-oh. Personal loan is 3 months old. I have a financial hardship now and I'm 1 month past due on all the accounts. Is it worth trying to settle at all? Will banks like Chase, B of A, Citi, Discover, Cap One, and Lending Club accept settlement in this position? Okay, so here's the issue. And this is something I've screened for as long as I've been doing this kind of work, for a couple of decades. Your ability to settle a debt is not generally impacted by the fact that you used the card last month to buy a bag of groceries or a tank of gas. Your ability to settle debt either at all or for the percentages and savings, you know, for optimal results, is definitely impacted by a creditor's policies and the way they view your account and the usage leading up to the fact that you could no longer pay. So, in direct answer to your question, can you settle with those types of creditors on those types of accounts, given what you shared with me? Absolutely not. You should not have that expectation at all. You can't expect to have hit a brick wall with places like Discover on balance transfers. You can hit a brick wall with all of the major credit card issuers when the balances are mostly the result of recent balance transfers. In some cases, recency is 12 months. Other cases, it could be 24 months since you made that balance transfer. My line in the calendar, in the sand, so to speak, is usually 12 months on balance transfers. Then you've got issues like recency of the account, right? So let's say you open up an account, a credit card account, $5,000 credit limit, and you max it up to the $5,000 available, using it for purchases and whatnot inside of a 6 month window, and then you stop paying. I'm not going to negotiate with you if I were your bank at that point in the same way I would with somebody who carried that balance and made the minimum payments for years and finally hit some kind of obstacle. So you have to expect that your settlements are going to be done usually at later stages of collection, maybe with a debt collector because the creditor won't negotiate with you. You might have to be dealing with a debt buyer who's that debt might ultimately get sold to. You might find that you're going to get sued, or at least your risks of being sued are higher because of account usage or account behavior. Another thing is, and I run into this more frequently now than I did in, say, you know, years past, decade or more past, is that the employment situation, or, you know, like right now, currently as I'm recording this video, in the oil industry, people are used to making really good money, and now a lot of those jobs are disappearing, and they rely optimistically on their credit cards to see them through to the next job, and the next job doesn't come as quick as they thought it would. We started seeing this more since 2008, actually, because of the recession. So now you've got these ballooned credit card balances, and it does matter how you use a card. If you use the card, and you've had it for 10 years, I don't care, and you didn't even owe anything on it, it was zero balance owed, but suddenly a job loss and things, and you just start placing all of your regular bills and living expenses on the card, suddenly it balloons in balance, even though you've had an established account for so long, that can also impact the settlement percentages that you can target or whether you can settle at all. So it's situational. Can you settle these things in these instances? I absolutely will be able to give direct feedback when I know a little bit more of the details. In this case, the reader shared quite a bit of detail is that Lending Club, for example, well, I just took the loan out 3 months ago and it's for $18,000 and now I'm not paying them. I'm suing if I'm a bank at that point. Everybody's specific circumstance in a situation like this can vary my feedback. So I do want the details. You can post them in the comments below. You can call in for a direct consult. This reader didn't really provide the details as to what hardship may have actually occurred to have just taken out an $18,000 personal loan 3 months ago and not be able to pay it anymore. Instances I've seen like that are a major medical issue, either of your own or someone in your family, a child. I've worked with clients that had gambling addictions, cash advance type of things off the credit cards. Those kind of scenarios, I can offer better feedback if I know some of the details that led to the hardship. So you can call in, post below. See you on the next video.